Good evening and welcome to Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks County. I'm your host, Amanda Machik, and tonight I'm joined with Kendra Cook and Becky Hughes, and we're going to be talking a little bit about the Berks Heritage Council. I'm the president, and Kendra is the vice president, and Becky is our secretary. So thank you both so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
The Berks Heritage Council was founded in 1990, and originally it was the Berks Museum Council, but the name changed, I think about maybe five years ago. Has it been
sounds
now?
Sounds right.
Yeah. So the Heritage Council is comprised of 16 historic sites, 15 societies, and 8 museums for a total of 39 members. We meet every other month, January, March, May, July, September, and November. And we tend to meet at a different site each month.
We were just at the Berks Genealogical Society.
Yep, on last Wednesday. Mm-hmm. So we have pictures of all of our sites here, and we would like to just tell you a little bit about each one. As we mentioned, we have both historic sites, outdoor living history museums, historical societies, all sorts. So the Albany Township Historical Society is
up in Kempton.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And their mission is to honor, collect, preserve, and interpret the rich cultural heritage of the township. And they are open by appointment. Ondelhay Heritage Center is in Rarersburg. Their library is open the last Saturday of each month. And I believe they have some special events as well. And
they do a lot of stuff around Christmas time. They have open houses and they really decorate. You know, they go all out at Christmas. And
I believe
they do quilt things too.
Yep.
I believe.
Oh, here's a photo, Christmas photo. And did they just have a book come out as well?
Yeah, they have a book on sale right now. I think about
Christmas.
The history of the town of Rarersburg. So if that's of interest to you, you should definitely contact them and grab yourself a copy.
Oh my, yeah, they have a lot of Christmas stuff.
Yeah.
All right, and as Kendra mentioned, the Berks County Genealogical Society, which is located inside the Goggle Works, right in downtown Reading, and we were just there for our meeting. They are open, I believe, they're open 7 days. Are they open 7 days a week?
They're open every day.
Yeah.
And all volunteers, that's pretty amazing, actually, to be able to be open every day when you have volunteers, but they're dedicated.
They are.
And if you've never been to the Goggle Works, I know the first time I went, I was really impressed with how easy it is to park at that building and get in.
And
you know, sometimes when you're in the city, you have to brave on-street parking, and it's really convenient.
Yeah.
So if you want to start your genealogical research for your family, that's a great place to start.
Great place to go.
And I believe another one of our members is located inside the Goggle Works as well, Polish American Heritage Association, which we'll get to a little bit later, but... All right. Berks County Heritage Center. Becky, since you are...
Berks County Heritage Center is located in Wyomissing between the Red Bridge, Topalkin Road, and 183.
Okay.
So near the Reading Airport. We do programs and things all year round, so you can come check us out. We do hikes and walks and things like that in winter.
Oh, here we go, the Heritage Festival.
There's a picture of the Red Bridge.
I love that picture.
Yeah. The one that you were commenting on the other day.
Yeah. We have a canal museum. Oh, we have the Gruber Wagon Works, and that is Mildred the houseboat.
All right. Aww. Berks History Center, which is formerly the Berks County Historical Society, which is also located in Reading. They are open. Well, their library is open Wednesday to Friday and Saturday, and their museum is open Tuesday through Friday and Saturdays. Again, the Berks Heritage Council has a website, which is berksheritagecouncil.org, but most of these individual sites have either a Facebook page and or a website as well that you can just Google and then find their full list of hours and contact information.
And the History Center does a lot of talks and programs.
Lectures.
So, you know, they're ones, they do a lot of events too. If that's something you're
interested
in.
They just celebrated an anniversary, didn't they?
Yes, they turned 150 in 2019. Boyertown Area Historical Society. I don't think we have a photo for them, but they're located in Boyertown, right on Chestnut Street, and they're in what used to be a Catholic church, which is pretty interesting, actually, in itself. They have a library as well. So they have some resources, too, if you want to work on genealogy or just local history. And they typically have, like, a program every month. And I think it's the first Wednesday of every month. February is going to be a program on the Lenny Lenape by Darius Puff, who has made the rounds here, so you might have seen him at other events. So he'll be there.
All right, Boyertown Museum of Historic Vehicles.
Yeah, I know something about that. the Boyertown Museum, we're kind of the neighbors to the Historical Society. We're over on Walnut Street, 85 South Walnut Street in Boyertown. And we're open 7 days a week, 9:30 to 4. And
let's see some photos. Yeah.
Pretty much everything we have on display is Pennsylvania built vehicles. And we do everything from carriages and bicycles up to cars and trucks. We cover the history of the state in road transportation, really. And we do a couple events throughout the year, too. So, if you're on Facebook, the best place to keep up with us is Facebook, because we update that pretty much every day. And that's just some of our stuff.
So. All right, Center Park Historic District. They're probably most well known for their Christmas open house, which just happened, I believe.
Got a lot of Christmas stuff going on in Berks. I feel like we're going to talk about that again later, too.
They also do the Artifacts Bank.
The Artifacts Bank, which I know, again, I'm not sure of their exact hours, but if you Google it, I know it is online.
That's really kind of incredible when you go back and walk through there, all the stuff that they have. So if you want to tackle some kind of do-it-yourself project at your home and need some sort of architectural piece, go to the Artifacts Bank. They have a lot of stuff.
All right, Conrad Weiser Homestead, home of Conrad Weiser. They are open, I believe they have seasonal hours, and they do have special events as well. I believe they will be celebrating Charter Day on March 8th.
That's when they reopen, I think.
For the season, I believe. Yeah. Yep, that sounds about right. Celebrating the signing of Penn's charter. And they are located out in Western Berks in Wilmelsdorf. Here are a couple photos. They do a lot of living history. French and Indian War.
Yeah, that's a really pretty site. The buildings are just really neat, and the grounds are so nice.
They do their patriotic concert. All right, and Daniel Boone Homestead, the birthplace of Daniel Boone. The site is located in Birdsboro, right off of Route 422. It is temporarily closed for the season, but will be reopening in the spring. I'm not sure the date that they will be open officially, but they will be celebrating Charter Day as well on March 8th to celebrate the signing of Penn's charter. Dreibelbiss Farm. They are in Hamburg, 18th century PA German farmstead. I guess it is actually located in Virginville, but the address must be Hamburg. They do events. I believe they have actually, they're doing the ice harvest.
Yeah, they're coming doing up. An ice harvest program.
Yes, so they are going to be doing an ice harvest, I think either this month or early next month.
I think it's February 1st.
Okay.
Yeah. And even if there's no ice, they still will have an event.
Program and talk about it. Yeah.
And if you go up there for the ice harvest, make sure you dress weather appropriate, because you'll be walking through some farmlands, so.
Okay. Comfy shoes.
Exactly. But yeah, you can see they do a lot of living history.
Yep.
Up there.
Very nice. And I think they do a big living history event in August as well. All right, Fleetwood Area Historical Society, obviously located in Fleetwood.
Yeah, they're in the, I guess that used to be the school, and I guess now it's like a municipal building.
Fleetwood Metal Body Company. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they have a museum, as you can see. Lots of memorabilia from the town, and there's a lot of like sports memorabilia from the town. There's, like you said, the Fleetwood Metal Body Company. There's a lot of photos and things like that, and neat place.
Okay, Friends of Robazonia Furnace, located in Robazonia. They do tours by appointment. Let's see if there's a photo. There we go.
They have a couple buildings.
I was going to say, they're located in the firehouse. Remember having a meeting there years ago.
Mm-hmm. Maybe it's due to go back there, huh?
Yeah, it's real blurry.
Some neat photos of what the town used to look like.
Yeah. Hay Creek Valley Historical Association, which is located at Joanna Furnace, home of the Hay Creek Festival, I guess, right?
Hay Creek Festival, Apple Festival.
They do the Christmas at Joanna.
Yeah, they do a Christmas too.
I think they are open by appointment and then have
special
events throughout the year.
They just did some work too on the furnace, didn't they?
They just redid the inside of the furnace,
and it's awesome looking. Mm-hmm. We were there last summer, over the summer, I guess, and it looked really neat. They did a lot of work there.
All right, Heidelberg Heritage Society. Let's see. Oh yes, they're in the Lurch.
Their building. If you drive 422,
I was gonna say it's in the Lurch Tavern. Obviously located in Heidelberg.
Warnersville.
I guess Warnersville, right? And the, of course, Warnersville train station.
Yeah, they got that not too long ago, I guess. And I think they did some work in there, and that's really a neat building. They have two really cool buildings.
I think they do a Christmas event as well and some other programs. Train station.
Got it.
Oh, goodness. Lots of photos from the train station. Okay. Historic Brinton Lodge.
Yes.
So they are on 724.
Down in Douglasville, right?
Douglasville, yep. I know they do programs at, like, Halloween and things like that.
Yeah, they do stuff.
They do a New Year's Eve event, I believe. Mm-hmm. And I know a lot at the... a lot for Halloween. Let's see what we got here. There we go. It is a huge house, huge home.
Used to be a restaurant, which I guess it sort of is now. It used to be called Cavada's. You maybe remember that from, I don't know, 10, 15 years
ago.
Yes,
and now it's Hidden River Brewing Company.
Yep. It's a neat history of the house. If you have an opportunity to go on the tour, I didn't really... know any of that, and I grew up not too far from there, and I really had no idea what all went on in that lodge. So it is pretty interesting if you get a chance.
Ah, yes, there it is. Mm-hmm. Toast with the Ghost. New Year's Eve. Oh, Valentine's.
Maybe lots of stuff.
Historic Preservation Trust of Berks County. They are also located, their headquarters are located in Douglasville. The trust preserves and maintains 8 historically significant structures at 4 different sites or properties. Throughout Berks. Buildings are open by appointment. This is a pretty, pretty, pretty old photo, but I believe this is the White Horse Tavern, which is part of More Latin Village in Douglasville. They also do several living history events, lectures throughout the year as well. Hopewell. Becky, you want to?
Yeah. Hopewell is located off of Route 345, just outside of French Creek. French Creek State Park is right there. They do programs usually April through the end of the year.
Okay.
All sorts of different programs.
Let's see what we got for. There you go.
So it's an old iron furnace. They do a lot of living history programs and farm programs. They also make their own charcoal.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool. Fun.
Ooh, cool. Mm-hmm. That's a charcoal, right?
That's a charcoal burn, yeah. Yep. And they do molding and casting demonstrations to show you how they made their stove plates.
Oh. Familiar face. Industries of Wyomissing Creek. They're obvious. Actually, they're in Moton. And they share knowledge about former industries which helped the area to prosper along or near the Wyomissing Creek. I think they have a Facebook page. I'm not sure. Do I have any? Oh, we don't have any photos. John Updike, childhood home.
You're right in Shillington. As you go down, well, it's still 724, isn't it?
Yeah.
Actually. Through Shillington, big white home. I don't believe they are open yet. I think they're still working.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you have any? No photos. Yeah. Kutztown Area Historical Society, is in Kutztown. I know they have the Victorian School Building, which contains has classrooms with artifact displays, research library, and they also have various seasonal hours of operation. Picture.
It's another neat building. So many neat buildings in our county.
Displays. Kutztown Folk Festival, which I'm sure we're pretty much familiar with.
Sure, always heard of that.
July, usually.
Week of July 4th. Big celebration of Pennsylvania Dutch folk life and culture.
Yeah, lots of living history, lots of art.
Shopping,
dancing,
crafts, music.
Oh, is that 8 o'clock?
And, yeah, 10 days, I think, so
yeah,
there's a lot to do.
Leesport Area Historical Society, that is, of course, in Leesport, in Ottolani Township. Or I guess it serves Burn Center, Ottolani Townships, Leesport, and Centerport, and they are open, I think, the first Sunday of every month, 1 to 4, or by appointment, and they're based out of the Leesport area schoolhouse off of Main Street. I want to say it's Main Street, but I'm, well, yeah, it is. That's
yeah,
it
yeah.
So. Yeah, right down from where the clock used to be, the clock is. So that, I believe, is the schoolhouse. Has a number of exhibits, and they do the annual Leesport Community Days as well.
They do stuff throughout the year.
Lectures, living history, magical history tour. All right, Leesport Lock House Foundation. They are also in Leesport.
Another cool building.
That is, yep, right down from the railroad tracks. They are open for special events. I believe they have regular hours as well.
Yeah, I think it's the first Saturday or
and you know, April through October, so they're seasonal.
They do some
as well.
Living history demonstrations as well. Oh my. Okay. Yeah. Lots of, okay. Mid-Atlantic Museum, which is probably
so they are
most well known for
183.
Yep, or Wayne 3.
Right at the Reading Airport.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And the World War II weekend.
Which is always the first weekend in June.
One of the biggest events in our county.
Yep, there we go. Oh, that's it. I thought more
plane. Running out of time. But yeah, there is a museum there too. So yeah.
All right, Museum at Crystal Cave, which is in Kutztown.
Yeah.
They have seasonal hours. I believe they're currently closed.
They open in April sometime.
Okay.
A little museum attached to the cave.
All right, Nicholas Stoltz Foods House. They are in
Wyomissing.
They're in Wyomissing on Tolfahocken Road.
And I believe they also have hours by appointment, and I think they do a couple special events a year, including a quilt auction, perhaps. Mm-hmm. Old Dry Row Farm. Warnersville, I was going to say.
I know where it is, but I wouldn't know what that town is considered.
I think it's on Brownsville Road, isn't it?
And they do a big, they do some blacksmithing things, I know, like in the...
Yeah.
So if you're into that, look them up, because they have a big event for that every year.
Of course, the Pagoda.
Pennsylvania German Cultural Heritage Center, which is right in Kutztown as well. Another PA German site.
Yeah, and that schoolhouse is.
All right, trying.
We've got the Easter egg hunt there. That's very popular. Yeah. So that'll be
Pine
coming
Forge,
up.
Which is in Pine Forge. They have hours by appointment, and I believe they're open seasonally on Sundays as well. Let's see. They got some really neat buildings.
Yeah, they do a Polish concert American. Once a year, too.
They are the other site that we had mentioned that is located inside the Goggle Works. Yep. They do a really nice Christmas display, which we just actually saw when we were at our meeting. Reading Area Firefighters Museum, which is located in downtown, downtown Reading.
Yeah, it's located on 5th Street in Reading.
And it's in one of the firehouse. Reading Company Technical and Historical Society.
They're in Hamburg.
That is the Reading Railroad Heritage Museum, which also, much like everybody else, has a great Christmas display. But they're open, I think, seasonally as well. I think they're reopening in March, maybe. Reading Public Museum, which is in West Reading. Celebrate science, art, culture, and history. Open daily, year-round, 11 to 5. Ridgewood Farmstead and Winery is in Birdsboro, a winery located in a historic farmstead. Yep. Really nice.
Lots of events.
Yep, lots of events. Roadside America, they are in Charlottesville. They have seasonal hours, again, probably pretty well known to most people. Sinking Spring Area Historical Society.
And then?
And Topahakan, and I think that is the end. All right, great, and we are out of time. So thank you so much for joining us tonight, and thank you guys for being here with me.
Oh, thank you.
We hope you learned a little bit about Berks. Interesting history.
There's lots here.
lots to do.
There's more. If you're in one of these groups that we didn't mention tonight, but you maybe want to be a part of the organization, we'd love to hear from you.
Yep. So. Again, you can reach us our website, BerksHeritageCouncil.org. Thanks so much and have a great night.
Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks on BCTV is supported by the Berks Heritage Council.